His work has been described as unfailingly original. His dancers have been called fearless. He has been given the title creative genius. And according to the LA Times, if there's such a place as dance heaven, Garth Fagan Dance knows how to get there. After 46 years of running a Rochester-based dance company and 25 years of operating a Western New York dance school, the mastermind behind the world-renowned Garth Fagan Dance continues to create and inspire. Tony Award-winning choreographer Garth Fagan joins me now to talk life, dance, and a special first look event for Rochester audiences. Garth, welcome. It is great to have you here.
Great to be here. Thank you. Nice sitting across from you, opposed to looking at you on the screen.
Well, thank you. Well, some people watching us right now on the screen, they are some of your biggest fans. And there are some tuning in and they're meeting you for the very first time. So for those who are getting an introduction to you, I'm going to take you way, way, way back to your childhood in Jamaica. And I understand your father, an Oxford graduate, he had other plans for you besides a life of dance. Is that right? So tell me about his plans versus your own.
Right. Well, Daddy believed in education, and he was chief education officer in Jamaica, so that was his job. And he wanted me to be doctor, you know, medical doctor, doctor, PhD, or whatever. And he thought dancing was just ridiculous. Anyway, in 1973, I had this passion to take my dancers to Jamaica. And I just wanted them to see how we live, you know, and all of that good stuff. So I took 16 dancers and lighting designers and whatever down to Jamaica. Charged it on my daddy's American Express card, because I had a copy for hotel and plane, you know. And got there, said, Dad, I'm not staying at home. I'm staying at the hotel with the dancers. And, you know, I was, what, 33, so I was very grand. I knew it all, everything. But anyway, I reserved a box for you. Please come. 8 seats in the box. He came with all 8 seats and came backstage afterwards. Oh, what a wonderful show. Oh, my son, the choreographer. I'm so proud of you. If you had told me that it had intellectual content and cultural significance, I never would have fought you as art. And the dancer said, you said he was so mean. You said he didn't. Right. What a nice man. And my brothers and sisters are laughing when they heard the nice man part, you know, because they hadn't experienced that either. But anyway, that sometimes you got to go with what you feel. And then when I told my son, I'll pay you back in 3 installments, he said, you don't owe me a dime.
Wow.
And that was music to my ear. But see, if I hadn't done that, he wouldn't have seen the company, and I wouldn't have gotten his blessing.
Right.
And while he was tough as nails, I loved him, and he loved me. And he made me who I am, you know. So I would have been wondering to this day, is this good enough for Daddy? Is this good enough for that? He was my standard, you know.
Yeah.
My mom was a sweetheart. She knew more about the arts than he did anyway, and she supported me 100%. But, you know, such is life.
Well, Garth Fagan Dance has been described by others as a combination of Afro-Caribbean and modern dance. And I want to know, is that the right description, or are there other elements and styles that need to be tied into
ballet, that? Ballet, ballet, ballet. They keep leaving off ballet, and I can't imagine why. I've choreographed a New York City ballet dance theater, Harlem. I still have a piece waiting for Stuttgart. You know, so, and contemporary forms, you know, salsa, hip-hop, whatever, movement.
Right.
I wanted audiences to see people dancing as opposed to dancers portraying people, you know. And that's what I wanted to see. I wanted to see, well, Alvin Ailey, my beloved friend and mentor, he gave me money in the beginning. He says, Garth, I hear what you're saying, but with all these dancers out here starving, why do you want to use untrained dancers? And I said, I didn't want any of the trained acumen, any of the fingers held and all of that stuff, you know. because they're contemporary people. Mm-hmm. They're dancing about women who run television shows, CEOs of Xerox or wherever. I mean, you know. I'm not going to get into politics.
Well, that's okay. Well,
My beloved Hillary Clinton. Good.
Well, I want to tell you, I watched your TEDx Jamaica talk. And and you mentioned that when you are working on a new dance, that sometimes you can get anywhere up to 20 ideas before you find something that really sticks. So I'm curious, what's the process like for you to get to that point where it does stick?
Solitude. I don't allow anybody, even my great-grandson will say, great-grandpa choreograph. He knows don't mess with great-grandpa, you know. He couldn't quite say choreographing, but he got the choreograph, yep. And he knew what it was. So he's now 9.
Those moments of solitude that help you to get to that point.
Yeah, so I can concentrate. Yeah. And not listen to the phone, not listen to TV, even when my favorite hostess is on. But I mean, focus, and distill. 1,000 ideas will come, and you gotta choose the ones that you can give a new dimension to, a new twist to, you know. And that will engage people, But it's hard work, and the movement is a whole other story because I gotta come up with the movement. Thank God I have Norwood Pennywell and Natalie Rogers, who are my Bessie Award, fellow Bessie Award winners, to help me, and their bodies are still in shape. Unlike mine.
Well, this month, Rochester audiences, they will get a first look at 2 new Garth Fagan dance works. This is before they're performed around the country in New York City and L.A. One piece was choreographed by you, one by one of your principal dancers you just mentioned, Norwood Pennywell. And this is really the first time that I understand Rochester audiences will get a first look at these new works in a number of years. So talk to me about your piece, In Conflict, 4 parts to it. What's the storyline behind this? Break this down.
In Conflict is what it means, in conflict, not conflicted. Because when you're conflicted, you've made a choice to be conflicted. Yeah. When you're in conflict, right, left, north, south, pink, blue, you know, everything is pulling you with play.
Exactly.
And it opens with In Conflict A, which Natalie Rogers, again, my Bessie Award winner, performs like heaven. I mean, she just, people are crying and uplifted, you know. Mm-hmm. Then In Conflict B is by Vittorio Jean, another one of my wonderful dancers. And he takes the male point of view, not as detailed and nuanced as most women are, but our rush ahead male attitude at solving things and getting through life, to show you another perspective. And then the two of them get together in a lovely duet, which we call non-conflict, because it's a warm relationship, but it needs a little bit more work. Yeah. You feel that, they feel that, you know, so it's not quite conflict, but work on it, you know? So non-conflict. And then the last section, Win Conflict, is for 7 dancers, including 2 of my burgeoning dancers, Sarah Herbert and Winnie. we call him Winnie. Anyway, and it's 3 love duets with one guy who doesn't have anyone yet but keeps checking it out and fooling around, you know. And the music is by Arvo Pärt, and he's one of my favorite composers. I've done 3-4 works to him before with much acclaim and reviews around the world. He's from Estonia. So that it ends on an upbeat, which is important because I can't stand negativity, negativity. There's a lot of negativity in life.
You say you want your audiences to find positivity in the pieces that you choreograph.
Right, absolutely, and leave out of there nuanced and enriched, you know.
I have read about and I've heard stories firsthand from some of your dancers when they first encountered Garth Fagan Dance, some as young as 11 years old, seeing the troupe perform in their home countries, and some of these same dancers finding their ways to the U.S., to New York City, up to Rochester to find you.
Shade Bully.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, it's
my
incredible.
My star, yeah.
And you've served as this model, mentor, and role model for so many. Who has served in that role for you?
Alvin Ailey. Martha Graham, tough as nails, but Lord, what a woman. And had me go across the floor 13 times because she wanted a simple, unadorned walk. Never showed us anything. And in that day and age, teacher showed you everything, you know. So anyway, she was very, very seminal. And her use of sculpture and stuff like that, you know. Really did. And Ivy Baxter, the head of the Ivy Baxter Dance Company in Jamaica, she was very, very instrumental.
Well, Garth Fagan, it's a pleasure to have you here. Thank you so much. And do not miss the Garth Fagan Dance Nazareth season. This is running from November 30th through December 4th. So this is your chance to get a first look at two new dance pieces, plus other revivals from the company's 46-year history. For tickets, go to garthfagandance.org.